Okay, cool. Okay, so today I'm going to speak about talent analytics a bit and you know the role it plays in the hiring process, improving the quality of hiring, the speed of hiring, and also an aspect of employee engagement in the organization. Analytics today is the buzzword. Everybody is speaking about analytics. Literally every article that we or every forum that we go into, there is a mention of analytics in it. And many of its associated bywords like artificial intelligence, automation, intelligent automation, cognitive sciences, many other things. So we're going to speak about a part of that. We will speak about bit of analytics and how it relates in HR is the you know specifics around it. Analytics in the employee life cycle itself, the whole corundum of it, the different areas and points that we cover in that, the quality of hire and how analytics plays a role on it, what can it do. I would take the liberty of showing you a few actual examples. You can call them examples, you can call them small applications that you know just put together so that it conveys the point with more clarity, as well as in the area of employee engagement. So a few examples again. So mostly the presentation that I would speak about is not only give you a context and perspective, but also take you through as many examples possible so that you know there is a very clear differentiation as well as very clear communication of what I mean by a few of those elements that make things successful in this field. And finally, we're going to talk about the different vectors of successful implementation of analytics that we have seen, especially in these areas, what is working, what is not working. We have been fortunate to have an experience of working with some large companies in this field of HR analytics. So we are seeing different lessons that you know should be incorporated by organizations who want to take this journey of analytics, specifically integrating it into the whole workflow and creating a different layer of differentiated insights. So that's the context, that's the coverage that we would have. We would have a dedicated question session towards the end. So if you have questions, you could type in. I mean, you know the process, so just type it into your chat box and I'll try to answer as many of them as I can. In case I do miss out because of time or I need some more information, I'm going to get back to you individually on the emails and you know and ensure that you get a reply to your questions. So you know when we talk analytics now, one of the elements which is today getting discussed a lot is how data has become the new oil, right? And let me take this analogy. So you know what happens in refineries and you know the whole oil industry is you have crude oil, which is you know something that you drill for underground or near the seashore and things like that, where you know there is all of these natural processes which are formed, which under pressure create the oil segment. You build a mechanism of piping it out into you know, a storage container. And then you take it to a refinery where you refine it. Now, a lot of you know, I'm sure would remember the process of refining or distilling oil, you know, undergoes through various stages and at different layers of temperature and pressure, different products are formed. You know, you have the base crude, which from there you extract. Right from petroleum products, the oil that we use in vehicles, the jellies, Vaseline, and in some extent, you know, additives into perfumes also. So there's a whole layer of outputs that come. Now, and each of these outputs individually are much more expensive and valuable than the raw crude that is drilled and extracted. Now, the whole process of analytics is very similar. You know, like the raw crude, you have your raw data or your transactional data, as we call it, which in the context of HR, if I take an example, it could be all the profiles of individuals who apply for a particular job, in an organization. It could be the life cycle inside the organization where, you know, you go through performance appraisals, compensation revisions, and all of that. So, you know,